What's going on, guys? It is Bernardo, and today is all about what is DNS. Now, this particular question is asked when you are interviewing for an IT job, so let's get right into it. All right, so what is DNS? What's DNS? Now, DNS actually stands for Domain Name System. It's basically like the phone book of the internet. Yeah, the phone book of the internet. So, we actually access information online through domain names, right? Like google.com, youtube.com, yahoo.com, outlook.com. But behind the scenes, like the web browser, whatever web browser you're actually using, like Google, Microsoft Edge, Internet Explorer, let it rest in peace, Firefox, Safari, those browsers actually interact through IP addresses. Right? DNS translates domain names to IP addresses so the browser can load the internet resource that you're trying to get into. So when you're typing in google.com, the browser actually behind the scene translates it into an IP address, goes to whatever server it needs to do, and then loads up google.com for you. Now, each device connected to the internet has a unique IP address, which other machines use to find that particular device. Now, for example, if you are working inside an IT world, right, you're an IT system administrator, most likely you have a web server inside your LAN room. That web server has a unique IP address. That IP address, that's how people will access that particular web server. But they're not going to type in that IP address within the browser. Most likely, you're going to provide a URL or a domain name to your clients. So when they type it in within the browser, it's going to go translate it to that IP address that you have on your LAN server and a web server, and then translate it to your website. Now, the DNS actually eliminates the need for us humans, to memorize IP address such as 192.168.10.1, right? It also eliminates us from memorizing complex IPv6 IP addresses, which 192.168.10.1 is translated to this right here, 00000FFFFC088. It's crazy. Who wants to memorize all that, right? So that's the reason why we have DNS. Now, how does DNS works? It works this way. It involves converting a host name such as google.com into a computer-friendly IP address for such as 142.251.41.14. Now, that's actually google.com IP address, and it always changes, okay? Each device on the internet is given an IP address, and that address is necessary to find the appropriate internet device in the internet world. Now, four DNS servers involved in loading a web page, and these are the four. One, you have a DNS recursor, and the DNS recursor is a server designed to receive requests from client machines through applications such as the web browser. So the DNS recursor, you could basically think of it as the first step of you opening up your browser and requesting that particular site. You have the root name server. The root server is the first step in translating and resolving the host name into an IP address. So as soon as you type it into your favorite browser, it's automatically translating that domain name, google.com, youtube.com, or bjtechnews.com, and it translated into an IP address. The next step is your TLD name server. Now, TLD basically stands for top level domain. This name server is the next step in the search for a specific IP address. It actually goes inside the phone book to locate this IP address, right? And if the host, the last portion of the host name in google.com, the TLD server is com. So if you have like edu or com or org, that is what the TLD name server does, right? Last step is the authoritative name server. Last stop, right? If the authoritative name server has access to the requested record, it will return the IP address for the requested host name back to the DNS recursor that made the initial request. So basically, if it's there, if the record exists inside the phone book, it shoots it back into the DNS recursor, which is you. Now, a nice, beautiful kind of image would be this. 7 steps. So step one, you are the user, computer, your laptop, you open up your favorite browser, you type in your google.com or Yahoo or whatever. It goes inside the second step, which is the DNS resolver. The DNS resolver goes inside the root server, which goes back inside the DNS resolver. The resolver goes to the TLD server, and then the TLD server goes inside the authoritative server. It goes inside the website. It goes back inside the authoritative server, and then the authoritative server goes into your computer to load your website. So those are the 7 steps. Crazy. Now, for a system administrator, IT administrator, senior, whatever, system administrators out there, we do have DNS servers housed within our 9-to-5 jobs. Like for me, within my lab, I have a DNS server within Windows Server 2019. And this is it. This is how it looks. I have a record, which we're going to go over pretty soon. What's a record? Because that's one of the mostly asked questions when you're interviewing for an IT job. What's an A record? What's a MX record? It's crazy. And I'm going to be doing like nice little series for you guys. So stay tuned for that. So as you can see, I have an A record that the IP address is assigned to 10.10.10.46. And the domain name is BTNHD-test. Now, I don't have to give the user the IP address. I could just give them the host name of BTNHD-test. When they type that in, it's going to translate into 10.10.10.46, and they're good to go. Even within servers, like you have a preferred DNS server and you have an alternative DNS server. For this example, my DNS server has a loopback. A loopback is basically it's calling its own IP address. My alternative DNS server is actually 8888, which is Google's server, which everyone is able to use it. And even at home with your wireless router, you have a domain name server as well. So this right here, this is a screenshot of a Netgear router, and the DNS is actually assigned to Google's DNS server. So it actually goes inside their phone book to authorize the domain name to translate to IP address. If it's there, it loads up the web page for you. So that's it. So that is what a DNS server is all about. Hopefully you guys enjoyed this video, and I catch you guys on the next one. Peace out.